the APCD, ACT, and ANUSRC. Hi, I'm Liam, an executive producer here at Woroni, and this is Woroni's weekly wrap-up for week 11. Earlier in the month, it was announced the ANU's Asia-Pacific College of Diplomacy would be de-established, following a review by a governing panel. Woroni revealed that this decision was made without consultation of either staff or students, and goes against the committee's recommendations, which suggested that the college be transferred to the Department of International Relations. In response, the review panel stated that these changes would offer a greater degree of structure and support, but concluded that the APCD was not sustainable in its current form. The 2020 ACT territory election has almost come to a close, with two seats in Junindera and Brindabella still in doubt. At the time of recording, Labor has won 10 seats, the Liberals 8 and the Greens 5. As a result, even if Labor wins both remaining seats, they'll still not reach the 13-seat minimum required to form a majority government. Labor will form government with the support of the Greens, as they did in their previous term. The first confirmed case of COVID-19 has been recorded in the ACT in over 100 days. On the bright side, ACT Chief Health Officer Karen Coleman confirmed that contact tracing has already begun and the risk to the community is low. SRC 7 ended the year with a bang, with several important motions passing after heavy discussion. The first of which was an election transparency motion aimed at keeping ANUSA candidates more accountable to their election promises. Similarly, a policy of ethical sponsorship was enacted after amendment to ensure that future ANUSA events, such as O-Week, source their funding from ethical organisations. That's all for week 11. Study hard and take care of yourself.